Welcome to this video demonstration of solid culture method for diagnosis of tuberculosis. The main constituents of the LJ medium, that is the Lowenstein-Jensen medium that is generally used, are the basic mineral salt solution with asparagin, glycerol, which provides the carbon source, malachite green, which provides a green background for identification of the colony morphology and to prevent the growth of the gram positive contaminants, and egg solution, which serves as the solidifying agent as well as for providing enrichment for the organism to grow. We will now see how the LJ medium is inoculated with the processed sputum deposit. This is how the plain LJ medium looks, onto which we are going to inoculate the processed sputum deposit. It has a little water of condensation at the bottom, which provides moisture for the growth of the organism. We have two processed sputum deposits here, which we are now going to inoculate on LJ medium. We can do the inoculation using the 5 mm twisted nichrome wire loop or using a disposable loop. A full drop is taken from the deposit using the loop. Which is about 10 microliter. It is spread onto the top surface of the LJ medium. Spread nicely, taking care to see that the inoculum does not run down to the water of condensation. After inoculating two slopes per specimen, these slopes can be incubated. We use two slopes per specimen because even in case one is contaminated, the other slope will be available for recording the final growth. The slopes are incubated at 37 degrees C for about 8 weeks. We will now be looking at how to read the growth on the culture in the LJ medium. Every week the slopes have to be read for observation of growth, contamination, or if the slopes are negative. These are negative slopes. These slopes appear contaminated. The negative slopes have to be incubated up to 8 weeks before they can be declared as negative. The contaminated slopes will have to be removed, and positive slopes will have to be identified using colony morphology and other identification tests, and then subsequently used for drug susceptibility testing or for any other molecular testing. This is how the organism appears in culture on the LJ medium. Typically or characteristically, it is called as rough, buff and tough. It is tough to emulsify, it is buff in color or a dirty cream color, and it is rough in texture. So, the positive growth is taken and it is graded again using the WHO IUATLD recommendation. When no growth is seen, it is recorded as no growth. When 1 to 9 colonies are seen, the actual number is recorded. When 10 to 100 colonies are seen, it is recorded as 1 plus. Between 100 and 200 colonies, it is recorded as 2 plus. If more than 200 colonies or a sheet of growth is seen, then it is recorded as 3 plus. We will now look at the advantages and disadvantages of solid culture for TB diagnosis. The advantages include that the culture provides definitive diagnosis and serves as the gold standard. It is suitable for all samples but requires decontamination to eliminate common contaminants. It requires about 1000 organisms per ml of sputum, and the isolate is available for drug susceptibility testing and also for strain typing. The disadvantages include the slow growth of the bacilli delays the diagnosis, which could be anything between 3 to 8 weeks. There is tremendous dependence on skill and infrastructure requirement, which may not be suitable for resource poor settings. It requires BSL-2 facilities, and only reference laboratories or high-end private labs can afford it. Cross-contamination can lead to wrong diagnosis. With this, we come to the end of the video demonstration on solid culture for diagnosis of tuberculosis.